Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Your Majesty, are you feeling poorly? Did those travelers cause you some trouble?
No, I'm fine. One of them reminded me of someone, but I must be mistaken. The magic mirror? But it's a precious royal heirloom. Why on earth do you require it? Explain yourself. I understand. However, as I have said, the magic mirror is a treasure of the royal family. I cannot simply give it to you.
I knew it'd say no.
C'est la vie, I suppose. It was a lot to ask.
So now what? How are we going to avenge my brother's death without that mirror?
If what you say is true, you must have survived a great many ordeals on your travels. That means your fighting skills must be on a par with those of my soldiers.
But, Your Majesty, you can't possibly plan to use those travelers instead of royal guardsmen.
Well surmised, Chancellor. Listen to me carefully. I rule with a fair hand, but I cannot grant every request that is made of me. However, if the royal family owes someone a debt of gratitude, I consider it my duty to fulfill it. You need the magic mirror. Then accept my request. If you complete the task I set forth for you, you may have the mirror. Summon the prince!
At once, Your Majesty.
The request concerns my son, Prince Charmles, to become King of Argonia. One must undertake a special initiation ceremony. There is some risk to life and limb, and the prince is unwilling to do it. As a father, the thought of putting my own son in danger pains me. But he must pass the initiation if he is to succeed me to the throne. It is the tradition of our kingdom. I was considering sending a detail of royal soldiers to protect him during the rite. However, I fear it will ruin his reputation. So my request is this. You outsiders will accompany my son to the royal hunting ground. Naturally, this would remain completely confidential. It is vital that everyone believes my son passed the initiation on his own.
Your Majesty, Prince Charmles is...
What is it this time?
The prince has run off again. I'm extremely sorry, Your Majesty. This is all my fault. I'll bring Prince Charmles to Your Majesty as soon as we can find him. As your humble and faithful servant, I beg...
You incompetent fool! Please pardon my outburst. But we cannot continue this discussion without my son.
Is there something on my head? Ick! Ick! A lizard! What's it doing here? Get it out! Get it out!
Thank you.
Ah, perfect timing. Allow me to introduce my son. This is Prince Charmles, the future King of Argonia.
What is all this, Father? Why are you wasting my time with this whiff-waff?
They're going to protect you during the initiation. They will need to know who you are.
Initiation? Who said anything about the initiation? I don't recall agreeing to that. I hate lizards. How many times do I have to tell you?
Listen carefully, Charmles. Enough is enough. I am aware of your aversion to the initiation, but it remains your duty to complete it. You won't be able to marry Princess Medea until you prove your worth.
Well, I don't care about getting married anyway.
You're making a mistake, Charmles. I hear Princess Medea is, well... Va! Va! Boom! You understand what I'm saying?
Wow!
Now, have you reconsidered?
You can leave me out of this, thank you.
Anyway, my son, do you realize what people say about you behind your back? This is your chance to prove yourself, to show the world you are a man. These people can assure your safety. Well, Charmles, do you accept?
Yes? Wait, no. I mean, oh, I don't know.
I heard a yes. That's my prince. I'll ensure that everyone believes you're doing it on your own. You will leave now. Hide yourself in the wagon at the city gates and await your bodyguards.
Right now?
Chancellor, accompany Charmles to the gate. The prince is leaving for his initiation. Summon the royal guards. The prince must have a fittingly ostentatious send-off. Remember, he is leaving on his own.
It shall be as you wish, Your Majesty.
But wait! I'm not ready yet!
Off at last. I wish you luck. And remember, your mission is top secret. Charmles will explain the details of the initiation himself. Fulfill my request, and you have my word that the magic mirror shall be yours.
Thank you.
Wagon is far too small for me. Maybe I could stretch my legs if you got rid of that worthless pot. Good grief! What's that? What kind of people are you, traveling with a freak like that?
Here, Grandad. You'd have bitten my head off if I said something like that. I'm a king, you half-witted twerp. A little closer. Look at us. Don't you see? We can't tell him his fiancée has turned into a horse. Much better to keep the truth a secret for now. Make sure everyone knows to keep it under their hats.
A Prince Charmless! What is our destination?
It's Charmless. Clot. Just head east. Eventually we'll come to the royal hunting ground. That's where the initiations take place. Oh, and before I forget... this vial contains a powder that masks human scent. You must sprinkle it on yourselves before we enter the royal hunting ground. Argon lizards are very sensitive to smell. If they get wind of our unmasked scent, they'll run away. In other words, we've got to smell like lizards to fight lizards. I'm supposed to be doing this by myself, so I shall be staying in the wagon until we arrive. I'll alight upon arrival, and we shall then proceed on foot. Now get a move on, you lazy rascals!
Thank you.
If it isn't Prince Charmles, I mean Prince Charmles. I suppose you must be here for the initiation, then.
Indeed I am, you uneducated bumpkin.
Oh! And who's this with you, eh? Last I heard, you royals had to go in alone.
They merely accompanied me here. They shall be accompanying me on the way home as well. I've instructed them to await my return just inside the royal hunting ground.
Oh, right you are. Well, I hope you have a good hunt then. I gotta be... Oh no, you can't go like that. You won't get no argon arch smelling like that, Your Highness. You wanna cover that up with something.
Thank you. Thank you.
So, this is an argon heart, but it's so small. Looks like the argon lizards aren't anything to worry about after all. We'll have to keep hunting lizards until we find one big enough to do justice to my heroism.
This from a guy who runs at the slightest hint of danger. Don't make me laugh.
Thank you.
No, this is no good either. We need to find a bigger one. The only way I'll get the respect I deserve is by returning with the biggest Argon heart the world has ever seen. So, we're going to keep going until we find one big enough to take back. Do I make myself clear?
Thank you.
This won't do. It isn't big enough to impress Father or anyone else, for that matter. If only there were some more Argon lizards, then we could fight them all and see if we got a bigger one. But those bothersome lizards keep running away and hiding when they see me coming. I'm just too intimidating for my own good.
Someone's pleased with himself. How much longer have we got to babysit this sissy?
Anyway, I'm hungry now. Servants, the day's hunt is over. Find level ground and prepare a campsite for my night's repose.
My horse isn't accustomed to being ridden. Come on now. Down from my horse at once, you fat oaf.
Shut up. I'll show you how to break in a horse. Stupid animal. Maybe a little pain will teach you. Calm down. Stop bucking. Stop. I'm going to fall! I'll whip some manners into you! You stubborn beast! You should be honored to have a taste of my crop! I'll teach you some proper respect for your rider!
That's my horse! Stop this at once! I simply cannot allow you to harass her any further. You must strike something. Strike me instead.
So, the horse is that important to you? Fine. Your wish is granted. Prepare to accept her punishment.
Oi, Gav! We got one! We got one! I was picking me now. I was picking me some flowers when I saw it. A blooming giant. One of them lizards.
Did you hear that? It's the cry of an Argon lizard! Forget the stupid horse! We've got to catch that lizard!
This is exactly what I needed. This will show Father and his servants. I can just see their faces now. Oh, Charmles, how wonderful. What a hero you are. They better, after all I went through to get it. Servants, back to the castle.
Last. It feels like a lifetime since we left on our epic journey. What's this? The flags are up. Oh, the bazaar is on. It must have started while we were away. I'm going to do a little shopping before I go back to the castle. Dismissed!
Thank you. Thank you.
There you are, and you've arrived just in time. Without further ado, allow me to present my new Argon Heart. The biggest you ever saw. I mean, you've seen a real Argon Heart for yourselves. You can tell this is no fake. I suppose you're wondering where I acquired it. Well, as luck would have it, one of the peddlers was selling one.
Service is our motto. We got another if you got the money.
Another? One is quite enough. Anyway, you can keep the Argon Heart from the Royal Hunting Ground for yourselves. I'm going to take this one back to the castle. You'll stay quiet about this, of course. And once the bazaar moves on, I won't need to worry about that peddler telling anyone. It's a flawless plan. Well, this is farewell. I'm off to the castle. Pop by sometime if you'd like to see the adoration on my subjects' faces firsthand. Ta-ta!
Oh, Charles. What have you done?
Prince Charmles, please show us the Argon heart you obtained.
Why, it's enormous!
I've never seen such a big Argon heart before.
It must be the biggest in the history of the initiation.
He must have slain quite an Argon lizard to get a heart of that size.
Prince Charmles, present the Argon heart, symbol of your bravery and worthiness, to King Clavius.
No. Wait. Charmles, do you swear before the Almighty Goddess that you obtained this Argon heart from an Argon lizard slain by your own hand?
Of course, Father.
Because even if, for example, you were assisted by others in battle, I would still recognize your claim to the throne. But if you obtained it by any other means, I could not recognize your right to the throne. Is that perfectly clear?
Yes, of course. I fought the lizard with my own hands, and a frightful beast it was too.
Very well, then I congratulate you. I accept this Argon heart as proof of your true character. I saw my son take an Argon heart from one of the merchants. Did you even take him to the royal hunting ground? I saw everything from up here. You must tell me the truth. Out with it! I see. So this is the Argon heart he obtained with your help. Why didn't he simply show it to me? I would not have cared about the size. I fear this means Charmles is far too immature to take the throne, or a wife. However, that is a matter between Charmles and myself. You did a fine job in taking him to the royal hunting ground. The magic mirror is in the royal vault on the fourth floor. You are free to take it whenever you wish. I have already instructed the guards to admit you. And I will take this Argon heart. It might prove useful when I need to remind Charmles of his foolhardiness.
Thank you.
Brought the magic mirror, if I'm not mistaken. May I have a look? That's odd. I don't sense any magic at all. Bereft of its magic power, it's no different from a normal, everyday mirror. Could someone have snuck in and tampered with the mirror while it slumbered in the royal vault? No, surely not. Nevertheless, even without its magic, the mirror remains a priceless royal treasure. What's that? The magical power of the mirror is central to your errand, you say? I see. Let me think. The mirror itself does not appear to be damaged. In which case, you should be able to recharge the mirror, so to speak, by exposing it to the right kind of magic. That would restore its former power. The man who taught me was a wizard and an expert in magical treasures. I'm sure he would know how to re-energize the mirror. Unfortunately, he is retired. Now he spends his days in seclusion in his home deep in the western forest.
Thank you.